In 2016, a video went viral. The video was of a student flipping a partially filled water bottle and having it land standing straight up. My kids and their friends now do bottle flipping and even make YouTube videos of bottle flipping challenges. The natural question about bottle flipping is, how much water do you put in to give you the best chance of getting it to land straight up? That's the problem we take up in this video. There are two main reasons the amount of water matters when flipping a bottle. There are others, I'll come back to a couple of those at the end of the video. The first is that the water can lower the center of gravity of the bottle. The lower the center of gravity, the harder it is to tip over. The second reason is that the water slows the rotation of the bottle. When you first start to spin the bottle on a flip, the bottle spins pretty fast. But what's happening is the bottle is spinning around the liquid water. It takes some time for the rotation of the bottle to get the water rotating as well. Since the water is heavier than the bottle, when it rotates, it slows down the rotation of the bottle. In physics, this is called conservation of angular momentum. There's the same amount of energy in the rotation at the beginning, when it's just the bottle rotating, as there is later when the bottle and the water are both rotating. But there's more mass being rotated then, so it can't rotate as fast. This is one reason why a rig slows down so quickly when you spin it. If you watch carefully on the viral bottle flipping video, you can see that the rotation almost completely stops and the bottle drops almost straight down. The amount of water doesn't affect the rotation of the bottle that much, because a bottle with less water takes less energy to initialize the spin, and the water will slow down to about the same rate as a fuller bottle, which takes more energy to initialize the spin, but has more water to absorb that energy and slow down that rotation. I haven't noticed a difference in my experiments with the rotational speed of bottles with different amounts of water. So let's focus on the other aspect of the water, lowering the center of gravity. As we add water to an empty bottle, the center of gravity of the combined water and bottle system lowers. An empty bottle has center of gravity about halfway up the bottle. Because the bottle is so light, even a little water at the bottom of the bottle will substantially lower the center of gravity. However, if we keep adding water, eventually the center of gravity will start going up again because the full bottle will have the same center of gravity as the empty bottle. To calculate the heights of the center of gravity, we use coordinates and a weighted average. We can put a scale on our bottle so we have coordinates to work with. Let's use the height in centimeters as our scale, with height at 0 at the bottom and a height of 20 at the top. We use weighted averages to find the center of gravity of two or more objects. We multiply the ratio of the total weights of an object times its coordinate, then add them together. It can be written in either of these two ways. Our video about 3D printing loaded dice goes into a more detailed explanation of this formula. You'll find a link of that video in the description. Center of gravities always lie on lines or planes of symmetry, and we'll model our bottle with objects that have nice symmetric properties for us to find the coordinates of the bottle and water. We're going to model our water bottle as a cylinder. Then the shape of the water will also be cylindrical. There are some values we need to know. The radius of the bottle, the weight of the bottle, the height of the water, and the weight of the water. The first two are measurements I can take or look up. My water bottle is about 6.5 centimeters in diameter, so 3.25 centimeters in radius. I looked up the weight of the water bottles, and 10 grams was typical. The weight of water would depend on the height. Since we're working with centimeters and grams, calculating the weight of water is easy, since it is 1 gram for every cubic centimeter. So we can calculate the volume of water in cubic centimeters, and that is the weight in grams. Let's write down our function with words for our quantities, then work on calculating each quantity. The center of gravity is the weight of the water bottle, times the coordinate of the center of gravity of the water bottle, plus the weight of the water, times the coordinate of the center of gravity of the water, all divided by the weight of the water bottle and the weight of the water. Now you know why mathematicians like to label quantities with one letter and not use whole phrases. The coordinate of the height of the center of gravity of the water bottle is halfway up the bottle, since it is symmetric about that point. So we can put in the weight and the coordinate for the water bottle. The coordinate for the center of gravity of the water is halfway up the height of the water. We're going to let the height of the water vary, so we're going to call it h. So the coordinate is h divided by 2. The weight of the water is the volume of the water, and we can use the formula for the volume of a cylinder to calculate the volume. It's the area of the circular base times the height. We know the radius, so we can plug it into this formula. Now we have the function to find. It gives out the center of gravity of the bottle and water system, given the height of the water. So what value of h minimizes this function? That's the height of the water we want to put in our bottle. If you have a calculus background, you can find the derivative and set it equal to 0 and solve. We can also use a graphing facility to find the approximate value of h that gives the minimum. If you graph this function, you might have to represent the height variable as x in the graphing facility to get it to graph. The graph shows that a height of about 2.2 centimeters should be the optimal amount of water. That's about 1/9 the height of the bottle. That is a lot less than the suggestions online which say to fill the bottle 1/4 to 1/3 to the top. Maybe our model isn't accurate enough. We modeled our bottle as a cylinder, but the top of the bottle is cone-shaped and it has a lid. The cone shape reduces the amount of material needed, so that would lower the center of gravity a little, but the lid tends to be heavier than the other plastic, so it raises the center of gravity a little. I'm going to assume these cancel each other out and the cylindrical model is still fine for the top of the bottle. The bottom of most water bottles isn't cylindrical. They have grooves or bumps. This would mean less water is at the very bottom than what we are assuming in our model. I have seen some bottles that use just a few bumps, so there's almost no water at the bottom of the bottle. Other bottles taper down to a smaller cylinder. I can imagine two ways to model this. One way is with the bottom of the bottle as a smaller cylinder. The other would be to replace the bottom 1.5 centimeters with a cone. These don't capture the actual shapes of the bottles, but we don't need to model the actual shapes, just a shape that would have a similar volume and similar center of gravity. These models could be used to represent a bottle that has a minimal taper at the end. The cone is supposed to be similar to an aggressive design with a few bumps at the bottom. It is easier to modify our function to fit the bottle model with a smaller cylinder for the bottom centimeter. I estimated that the radius of the smaller cylinder should be about 2.5 centimeters. Now we have three objects to combine to get to the center of gravity: the bottle and the two water pieces. Let's just keep the bottom centimeter full, since we're sure the optimal amount will be higher than 1 centimeter. Our new function looks like this. The height of the water in the main part of the bottle is the only part that is changing, so we need to adjust our h values to fit the new model. And that is where the x minus 1 term comes in, or h minus 1 term. The optimal amount is about 2.5 centimeters up from the bottom. The center of gravity is higher now because we don't have as much water at the very bottom of the bottle in this model, so it can't pull the centroid as far. 2.5 centimeters up from the bottom is only about 1/8 full, still much less than the recommended 1/3 or 1/4. Some bottle designs are even more aggressive. We could modify our model even more by making the bottom cylinder even smaller to see how much water we should add if we have one of those bottles. Let's reduce the radius for the bottom cylinder to 1.5 centimeters. In that case, the optimal height is around 2.8 centimeters. So the more aggressive the cutaways at the bottom, the higher the water level should be. I mentioned earlier that there are other ways the amount of water can affect the flipping of the bottle and having it balance. The water can be sloshing around, which affects the center of gravity and can cause sideways force on the bottle. I don't know how to account for this in such a simple model. Another issue is that a heavier object can be harder to knock over, even though it has a higher center of gravity than a lighter object. So maybe it would still be better to add more water than we found in our analysis. For this, I thought I'd do a quick empirical test. I had a bottle filled with water filled to 1/8 the height, and another filled to 1/4 the height. I personally had better success with a bottle with the less water, like our model would imply. But you can try it too. Tell us in the comments how it goes for you. Of course, practice is a large factor in this as well, so if you're already used to having a lot of water in the bottle, it'll take some time to be consistent with a bottle that has a different amount. So be sure to practice enough with both that you have a fair comparison. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.